Sadak 2 is a 2020 Bollywood action-drama film directed and co-written by Mahesh Bhatt and stars Sanjay Dutt, Pooja Bhatt, Alia Bhatt, Aditya Roy Kapoor, among others. For those of you who don't know, this is the sequel to the 1991 film Sadak, and after the overwhelming positive response on the trailer, I mean, I cannot believe how many six got. I can't say I was in much surprise though. Even I didn't dislike the trailer at all. So it even got a little bit of a dislike from me as well. The fact that this is a continuation of the 1991 film is a very big disappointment. I actually reviewed the movie prior to this film. I think it's when the trailer came out that I uploaded it. I've been wanting to watch the film because I'm a completionist, but because of all the rage that was happening behind this, I decided to postpone it a little bit, and I feel like right now people are a bit more calm than back then, because if you even utter the word Sadak 2, even if it is in your title, it's going to get a dislike. So I just wanted to avoid that, and I wanted people to be a bit more calm and, you know, a bit more collected. And I wanted to keep this review short, so here it goes. This film is worse than Lakshmi, and I don't know who says Lakshmi was the worst film of 2020. Compared to this, I would much rather watch Lakshmi, because this film is so boring, and this film had nothing in common with the first Sadak. It had the exact same story, just with a different character. Even Sanjay Dutt's character is the exact same story. There's hardly any kind of, you know, a variation on it, or any kind of, you know, first of all, the fact that Pooja Bhatt is in the cast is like the biggest insult to the movie. One of the biggest insults, because if you watch the movie, which, and if you live through it, congrats. But there is no reason why you should put Pooja Bhatt's name in this movie, because she's there only as a voice, and any appearance she has in the film are all from the first film. They just cut out a few scenes and mash it in this. That's what their idea of being in the cast means. I have no idea. I don't know the logic there. You guys have to tell me about that. So Sanjay Dutt is back to the same old formula. Everyone he knows is dead. He has a new friend now. Alia Bhatt suddenly comes into his life. She has the same exact story as that of Pooja Bhatt, with a slight variation on few things. Aditya Roy Kapoor is a dude who's just there in the background. He's mostly there to react to things. They try to hand-fist a story for him, but it's basically the story is very, very predictable in every single way. You know exactly what the next whole movie is going to happen once it begins. I've seen Priyanka Bose in Pariksha, and I would much rather watch more of that than this, because Priyanka, every single character acts like they're fucking children. I don't know who, like, if Mahesh Bhatt wanted to direct, I understand the marketing gimmick, because Sadak is one of his most popular films. But goddamn, why are you directing them to act like children? Even the dialogues are some of the worst. If any of you have seen the trailer, you know the worst dialogue in the film is the one said by Alia Bhatt. Bhagwan hamare saath hai, yahi isi sadak par. And from where is she saying it? On a staircase. The whole movie is packed with these outdated dialogues that I don't know if anyone speaks in this day and age. In 1991, it made sense. That's the kind of film that was popular back then. And Mahesh Bhatt, as a director, he knows to tell good stories. I've seen some of his films, and that had good story in it. Even Sadak, the first Sadak, was entertaining in some aspects. The villain is the worst. They build him up to be this evil mastermind, but again, the story is so predictable, you know where it's going the very next scene. You tell me one thing. Jishu Sengupta is in the movie. He plays Alia Bhatt's father. And he's like the most innocent person in the whole world, and he's the CEO of a company. Do you really believe that for even a second? I just want to end this as quickly as possible. Sadak 2 gets a 2 out of 10. This is the worst movie of 2020, hands down. Maybe Virgin Manupriya is a competitor, but compared to this, Lakshmi is like a masterpiece. Compared to this, you have to understand that. I would much rather watch that than this. This was so boring, and if this was not even releasing, I would never have even touched Sadak. I don't want to rant on it too much. Here's the only good thing in the movie, and that is the songs. And I'm glad at least they got that in mind, because if you don't know, one of the reasons Sadak was popular was because of the songs. It was so great that after watching this film, I even went and saw some of the old songs from the first Sadak just to pacify myself. Otherwise, I would be like flipping out, and I don't want that to be in a video. So the songs individually is good. The execution of it is so bad. I don't ever want to see them. I would much rather listen to the audio of the song, and that's like one of the best things in the movie. That's pretty much it, and I want to share some experience with you while watching this. I was not expecting today to be like this rainy day, considering we're nearing winter. But if you checked outside my house, it's pouring rain, and I never expected this. Normally when rain happens, there's going to be a power cut, but no. But then I thought, you know, it's such the atmosphere outside that even God himself has given for me. This is like the perfect opportunity to watch one of the, what many people are saying is the worst film of 2020. There's even an IMDb rating of 1.1, and I know why it's 1.1 word brigading, I know. But there is some sense to it though. It's so bad. There's two more of these multiplex movies to go. So yeah, the rain is something which I did not expect. Kind of provided a very good atmosphere though. And yeah, watched it on Hotstar. It's available there. I don't know why you would ever want to watch it. Makarand Deshpande is a joke. He is like one of the worst things in the film. By far, he's like the worst aspect of the film. Period. And the entire movie is bad. I say avoid it. That's it. And that's all for my review of the movie Sadak. Thank you guys so much for watching this. I appreciate it. Please give this video a like. Share this video with your friends and family and all anyone you know. Please hit that subscribe button and hit that bell icon too, so that you'll be notified when my videos are coming out. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'm going to start Marvel Phase 1 now. Taking another break because I need some break. I want to end this year with Kali Piri though. That's like one of my requirements. That's another movie that people have said are bad. I want to end this year on a high, because this year was so bad. Anyways, I'll see you in the Iron Man movie, which I'm going to do next. Phase 1 starts with Iron Man apparently. See you in that video. Bye. I'm walking alone, the streets are empty. The only thing I can see is my own silhouette. I'm getting stronger, step by step. The clock is ticking, but there's no time for me. I've been